Duck Duck Goose is an upcoming 2018 computer animated film that tells the story of Pang, a self-centered bachelor goose who likes flying dangerously instead of with his flock. When Pang accidentally intercepts a few baby ducklings, he goes on a journey to return them to their flock and learn what it means to be a father figure. The first trailer just hit yesterday, and if there's one thing I've learned from it, it's that the creators would lead us to believe that the world needs more jokes like this in our animated films. Let's take a closer look.
Mix a story with the laboratory, get a story laboratory.
One thing that's worth noting about the minds behind Duck Duck Goose is that the writer and director, Chris Jenkins, is also known for being the head of story, writer, producer, and director of Surf's Up, one of the early films from a different studio, Sony Pictures Animation, which actually was pretty well received by critics and successful at the box office. While these two stories are wildly different, there's definitely a similar sense of humor when it comes to the kind of easy jokes and gags that appear on screen. Looking at the story of Duck Duck Goose, or at least what's been revealed so far, one thing that really stands out to me is that Pang is kind of an all-around jerk and comes off as very unlikable.
Can I run on your shoulders?
Not a chance.
Looking back at some of the animated films that were released over the last year or so, we can see that the jerk protagonist has been a popular choice lately. The Emoji Movie, The Boss Baby, The Lego Batman Movie, The Secret Life of Pets, all of these films are led by a less than likable main character, and Duck Duck Goose is no different in that regard. The jerk character can work if done right, but something a lot of these stories are missing, and something I'll really be hoping to see in this movie, is a save the cat moment. In his screenwriting book, Save the Cat, Blake Snyder describes a moment that occurs near the beginning of many stories that is designed to show us that there's a hint of goodness in our main character, even if their normal state is jerkish or mean-spirited. In Pixar's The Incredibles, for example, Mr. Incredible quite literally saves a cat from a tree in one of the opening sequences, which serves the story well because now we know that although Bob has some changing to do, the potential for growth is there. Something else about this film that concerns me a little bit is the issue of Pang's motivation to achieve his external goal. While it's made clear in the trailer that Pang's goal becomes to return the chicks to their flock, his decision to help them seems a little unnatural, given his selfish and me-first attitude.
So we got separated from our flock. Can you help us or not?
I would say I'm an or not.
Stop. Fine.
Come on, let's go.
What I'll be looking for in the finished film will be a good reason for Pang to accept his call to adventure. If he's not kind and generous at the beginning of the story, there needs to be something in it for him, so to speak, when he agrees to help the chicks. So we'll see if that character choice is well-earned or not. Overall, I'd say Duck Duck Goose doesn't look too promising, but I think if the film ends up including things like a save the cat moment and a clear sense of motivation to achieve a goal, it's definitely gonna help. Thanks for watching this episode of Trailers and Test Tubes, and if you enjoyed yourself, hit subscribe to see more like it. As always, remember, story is king above all movie things.